We are back at the Jemison Empire Awards 2016 with Maisie Williams. Hello.
How are you? Evening.
I'm not too bad. Yourself?
Good, thank you.
Excellent.
Really
excellent.
Good.
Not to be too Ryan Seacrest, this is a fantastic dress you got on.
Thank you. It's a top and a skirt.
A top and a skirt.
But
there you go.
I love it. It's from by Sadie Williams.
Well, there you go.
Maisie Williams wearing Sadie Williams.
Oh, hang on. The universe is converging. This
totally.
Is so bizarre. Yeah. Well, see, this is why Ryan Seacrest would know that was a top and a skirt.
It's okay.
Yeah.
I forgive you.
I've made a terrible, terrible mistake.
Honestly, I only know it's a top and a skirt because I put it on. Otherwise, I wouldn't know that it was a top and
well,
a skirt.
Well, this dress took me ages to put on, so...
I see. Nice top and skirt.
Well, thank you very much indeed. Thank you. This is by a top man, I believe. So yeah, how's it going? You looking forward to the night?
Yeah, I've never been to the Empire Awards before, so I'm really looking forward to it. Yeah, I can't comment on what it's going to be like. It'll probably be terrible. No, I'm kidding. No, I'm
so this is very much like everything you're doing at the moment. You can't comment on Game of Thrones Series 6.
Can't comment on... Yeah, no, not much. Uh-huh. I mean, you could try.
Okay, let's try. So in which episode do all the big deaths occur?
An array of episodes.
Many, many episodes, as a matter of fact. It's Game of Thrones, you may have noticed. Right. This is the first season in which the TV show has accelerated past the books.
Yes.
So everyone's in that kind of...
Yeah, I think, like, honestly, this series works much better as a series on a whole because they can put the major plot points in whatever episode they want rather than conforming to a previously written story.
Yeah.
They can now shape the whole series for every storyline the way that they like. So for me, I feel like my storyline flows a lot nicer than it ever has before. And although I'm not in as many episodes as I previously have been, it still feels like more story being told. It's strange. It's really strange.
Is that because the story is now so big, there's so many characters that everyone gets a little less screen time?
Right, but then also a lot of people keep dying, so everyone gets a little bit more screen time.
Okay.
Pros and cons.
So when you say things like, I'm not maybe in as many episodes as before, we shouldn't read too much into that, right?
You'll have to watch and see.
Okay. it's all very exciting. But has that brought a new kind of atmosphere to the set? And when you're reading scripts, do you now read them kind of peeking through your fingers?
I guess I was a little bit, but it's just interesting to see where the story's going. And then you never know, obviously, what's going to happen, but you see where your story is going.
Yeah.
You know, it's not... Well, I mean, sometimes it is very sudden, I guess. I don't know.
We shall see.
We shall see.
But has it been... What's it been like on the inside of this phenomenon? Because now there's such a hullabaloo about Season 6. It is bigger than it's ever been before.
Mm-hmm.
When you started, 6 years ago now, did you expect to get to this point? Did you expect it to be as big as it is now?
Not at all. No one could have predicted the scale that this show has now got. No one could have predicted that. I think the writers probably pitched it to HBO like that. Like, this is going to be the next biggest thing ever. But no one really thought that that could actually happen. And I was just really excited to be cast in something. And then now I'm like, whoa, this is my life forever.
This is it.
25
years.
Yeah.
Unless.
Who knows?
No, of course not. Yeah, of course not. And while you're here, I have to ask you about the Last of Us as well.
The Last of Us. Well, that's something that I still very much like to do, but there's no movie being made, so...
What is happening? Because I was at Comic-Con a couple of years ago, Sam Raimi
was
there.
And there was, like, so much hype, and now everyone's like, what's going on with The Last of Us? I'm like, boy, I wish I could tell you. I have no idea.
Okay, so keep them peeled. You never know.
Yeah.
You never know. Well, have a great night.
If you hear anything, let me know.
I will let you know immediately. Maisie Williams.
Evening.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Enjoy yours. Take care. You. Amazing. Maisie Williams, we love you. Could you say hi to Jude? She's gone. Spring is coming. Your accent is great. Fantastic. Peter Serafinovich is in the house. Hello, sir.
How are you? You alright? You alright?
It's always good to have an awkward handshake / hug live on Periscope at the end.
Oh, are we on Periscope?
We're on Periscope.
Oh, great. Fantastic.
How do you feel about Periscope?
How do I feel about Periscope?
We're watching you now on Periscope. Be pretty careful.
Watching now on Periscope. Hello. Hello. So does this mean everybody watching now is on a submarine? I'm kidding. I know what Periscope is. Hello. Anyway.
Hello. How are you?
It's none of your business. No,
oh, okay.
I'm sorry.
I should start with the intrusive personal questions.
To be honest, man, I've got a bit of a cold. But apart from that, so sorry for the hug. I should have apologized. I should have not hugged you, really.
Well, I instigated it, if anything.
Yeah.
It's kind of my fault.
it's really nice to see you. It's
yeah,
a
likewise.
Treat to see you. I always enjoy seeing you, Chris.
Oh, likewise, Peter. It's great fun. So tonight you're here representing Spy.
Representing Spy, yes.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Which was a huge hit last year.
It was great. Yeah. It was, you know, it was such fun to do, and it's great to be part of something that you really like, you know,
yeah.
So what a lovely treat to, you know, to have done it and for people to nominate it for an award. What am I talking about? I'm rambling. I've got a cold. I think I'm sort of something. Lemsip has sort of taken over 80% of my brain. And
that was all cogent, by the way. That was a complete sentence. It made perfect sense.
Good. What does cogent mean?
It means perfect sense.
Okay.
Yeah. That's what I'm thinking anyway.
How are you?
I've got a cold. You've just given me a cold, so I've no idea what I'm saying. I'm very, very good. Spy looked like great fun to make. I mean, Paul Feig is a director. There's obviously a script. You adhere to the script, but that's the improvisational side run wild as well.
No, he doesn't let it run wild. You stick to the script, and then he will give you... you'll do the scene a couple of times, and then he and his usually female co-writer will think about some alternate lines, and he'll come over and secretly give you a little post-it with, why don't you say this instead of this line? Like secretly,
okay.
So like if I was doing a scene with Melissa,
yeah.
She wouldn't know what I was going to say, and I would always also be able to pitch lines to Paul as well, and he would sometimes let me do them, but most often he would say,
That's it. So Melissa doesn't know what you're going to say. Does that mean that sometimes you make a corpse, or do actors pride themselves on holding it together?
No. Yeah. Well, she did the opposite, which was like the first scene that we did. She started crying in the scene, and I just got off the plane the night before, and we were in the middle of the scene, and I said to him, "Hey, are you okay?" And then she was like, "I'm acting, you dummy." I was like, oh, right, acting, okay. What I'm supposed to be, right, got it, okay.
Well, it's very, very good. Well done. You know, you should deserve some award.
I think they cut that bit out of the film.
Oh, the bit where you just broke character and started apologizing.
I think so, yeah. Some eagle-eyed editor, I think, hopefully spotted it.
As far as I remember, it's not in the film.
Right.
What's next for you?
I've just done, actually, I haven't told anyone this. I've just done a porno. No, I've just done a... I've just done
Up Periscope?
Yeah, it's called Up Periscope. I've done the... I'm in John Wick 2, which was amazing fun.
Wow.
Yeah, so I'm in that. I've just done a film with... did a film with Michael Caine, Morgan Freeman, and Alan Arkin.
Uh-huh.
Called...
Going in Style.
Going in Style. Yeah, directed by Zach Braff.
Yeah.
And that was about three old guys who rob a bank. Yeah. So I was in that. And,
do you play the bank, or who do you play?
That's very funny.
I did try.
No, it's good. I play Michael Caine's son-in-law in that. And that was mainly all my scenes, really, with him, you know?
Because you've done a Michael Caine impression. I've seen your Michael Caine acting masterclass sketch.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
Does that come up when you're talking to the great man?
Well, you know, I think most people have done a Michael Caine impression.
This is true.
You know, and I wanted to tell him about it, and I thought, oh, God, you know. He said, on the first day, he said to me, we were doing my close-up, he said, look, just keep your eye, when the camera's on you, keep looking at me, but with the eye that's close to the camera, just look at me just with that eye. Don't switch eyes and don't blink. And I said, yeah, look, I know that. I know it because I'm obsessed with your masterclass. In fact, I did a sketch about it. And look, so you don't need to tell me. It's like the best acting advice I've ever got. And it's true, you know.
Yeah,
and then he said, yeah, it works, though, doesn't it? It works. And it does work. It does.
The don't blink advice has stayed with me throughout my life. I mean, I don't act, but I just try not to blink at any point.
Okay, yeah. They do look very dry, your eyes, actually.
I just blink there now. I have to blink at least once a day, otherwise things go wrong. But I just got a couple of things before I let you go. What's the situation with the Brian Butterfield sitcom?
I don't know. We did a read-through for the BBC a couple of months ago, so I imagine in about 2026 we'll know something.
Is that a 26 minutes past 8 or is the year of 2026?
Who knows?
Well, I wish you all the best, man.
Thank you.
I think it's going to be very, very funny.
All right. And this looks amazing. It looks fantastic.
It's going to be a good old shindig.
Yeah. That's brilliant. Lovely to see you,
thank
man.
Thank you very much, Steve. Thank you.
I'll see you later.
Indeed. Peter Serafinovich there. Live. Giving you awkward hugs live. He went with the hand. He leaned in looking like he wanted the hug. I wanted the hug because he's a very huggable guy. So in I went and in I goes. Consigned my list of awkward hugs with celebrities. It's a long old list. A very, very long old list. We've got someone else coming up very, very soon here at the Jameson Empire Awards. A very, very, very special guest. I can see him. He's hugging Peter Serafinovich. So now he's got his cold as well. Who was that chap? That was Peter Serafinovich. The star of Spy, the voice of Darth Maul in Star Wars Episode 1, The Phantom Menace, and all sorts of stuff. And speaking of people who are in Star Wars, it's Andy Serkis.
Well, hello.
Hello, sir. You all right?
I haven't seen you since this point last year.
I haven't moved. I don't see they keep me here in a box.
This is amazing.
How are you?
I'm very, very well.
You're good.
How are you?
You were live. Live.
Oh, my God.
On Periscope.
Oh,
so I was going to say, watch your language, but you can F and Jeff as much as you want. It's all very, very good. People are saying, hey, Andy.
Hey, how
Ian
are
Duty.
You?
That's autocorrect.
Caesar, precious. Hi, Snoke.
Basically, now just listing your great roles. It's been a hell of a year for you, though, hasn't it?
Oh, man, it's been busy. Yeah, it's been pretty fun. I've literally just got back last night from Canada shooting War for the Planet of the Apes. So.
Wow.
So, yeah.
How close are you to finishing it?
On that?
Yeah.
Oh, well, no, it won't be out for another year because it comes out July the 14th next year because of all the post-production.
Are you still filming or what are you
doing? No, I'm done. I'm done on it. We literally just wrapped.
Wow, okay. Yeah. So you're in the mood to party hard, is that?
Very hard.
But then again, you're also directing Jungle Book Origins.
That's true, but that can start again tomorrow.
Okay. So you have to put everything on hold for a little while just to get going. And of course, hell of a year, as I said. So you showed up in Avengers Age of Ultron, had a great speech by Cuttlefish, which I believe was a Joss Whedon speech. Something you're obsessed
it
with.
Was. No, he's obsessed with Cuttlefish, I think.
He's obsessed with Cuttlefish?
I think so.
Okay. And then, of course, Supreme Leader Snoke in, I believe, it's Star Wars. Yeah, Star Wars.
It was just before Christmas, wasn't it?
Yeah. A small little film.
Yeah.
It did nothing at the box office.
I know. Sadly.
What was it like, though, being on the inside looking at that phenomenon unfolding?
It was extraordinary. I mean, you know, everyone said, oh, you wait till this all starts to really kick off. And I was just thinking, well, yeah, I know. I kind of been around a bit, seen how these movies work, you know. But it was phenomenal. I mean, it's just extraordinary to see how, JJ just hit the bullseye with just... It was sat at like a beautiful, satisfying meal for the Star Wars fan, I think, that movie. And, it just really... just hit home. It just, it's great. And I think it's a really fantastically crafted movie, and the great breakout performances by John Boyega and Daisy, it was great.
I think it's the real deal.
Absolutely. Yeah. Yeah.
And what about yourself? Have you been on Episode 8 yet? Is that in your near future?
No, because I've just come back from Canada, but that's not far off, and I will be working with Ryan, so looking forward to that.
Interesting. So we'll get the full revelation, the full disclosure. And maybe you can help us out here. Is Supreme Leader Snoke actually only 6 inches tall?
I thought nobody was supposed to know that.
Giant hologram.
No way.
Little man. It makes perfect sense.
No way.
Perfect
That's
sense.
That's going to spoil it.
Well, what about the voice? Where did that come from?
We just worked on that. We spent... JJ and I mean, it was a very interesting process because it's the first time I've worked on a character that neither he as a director nor I knew exactly how it was going to finally be manifested on screen. So in most of the other characters that I've played, there's a very solid sense of what he's going to look like but this was a real sort of process of invention and working on the character, working on voices, working on physicality, and then over a long period of time, we shot on set, of course, at Pinewood, but then we would have these sessions where we'd revisit those scenes at the Imaginarium, which is my performance capture studio, and JJ would be in LA and he'd Skype over, and then we would literally continue to evolve it and change it until we finally arrived at what you see in the movie.
Oh, wow, fantastic. In terms of eyelines in that movie, That always fascinates me with when you're doing mocap work, CG work. And I know in Avengers Age of Ultron, James Spader was basically 9 feet tall. They put a giant...
That's right.
Almost like a crane on top of his head, for you to get the eyelines right. What about you as Snoke in this movie?
Well, I was actually up on a 25-foot podium. I mean, it was quite... Yeah, it was quite... isolating experience, you know, because there was Donald Gleeson and Adam Driver down there below and on the deck, and I was sitting up on this, literally this 25-foot podium on a throne, and then my voice was being projected out through speakers so that there was a sense of scale. But it was yeah, I mean, it was a kind of strange, you know, walking onto a set and because it's the introduction to that character, though, you know, the scenes were quite, you know, small and compact, but being that away from everybody else was quite a strange experience.
My God, I can imagine. And tonight you're presenting
Best Film.
Presenting Best Film. So let's take Star Wars out of the equation. What's your best film?
I mean, oh God, it's so difficult, isn't it, with all of these things. How do you compare? But look, I love Room. I think Room is a great movie, and Revenant, I think, is a brilliant. And they're all good films. The Martian I enjoyed thoroughly, you know. So I think Revenant will probably come through. Mad Max 2. I mean, the thing is, it's
tough,
hard. It's really hard. Yeah.
It is very, very tough indeed. And Andy, I'll let you go in a second. But the Empire Awards, I mean, you're very much a staple of this. It wouldn't be the same without you. What's it about the awards that you look forward to every year?
Look, they are by far the most exciting and fun events, and I think it's a lot to do with the fact that it's a big party, and you see so many people you knocked around with last year and kind of made me shamefully ran away from, you know, at the end of the night from last year, and you know, it's just really great re-engaging with people, and it's so relaxed. That's the thing. It is really good fun.
Absolutely. Well, I'll let you go and relax. I will see you next year, same time.
Okay, so
same day.
Yeah.
I'll be here in a box.
Absolutely.
Right. Andy Serkis, pleasure, man. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Cheers.
Brilliant. Andy Serkis there. Sorry, I didn't get to read all the comments and questions. The latest guest on today's arrivals at the Jemison Empire Awards 2016. And we may be back with someone else in very, very short notice. In a couple of minutes, I will let you know. Can I have some work experience at Empire? There is actually a way you can do that. I think if you go to gothinkbig.co.uk, it's a website, and they handle all our work experience. If you do want to come into the office, you get 2-week placements. And my wife has just said hello. Hello, hey, to my wife. You can apply for there and come and sit with us depraved, debauched idiots at Empire for 2 weeks. And get to do some transcription and some writing and make some tea. It's all very, very exciting. Right, that is it. I'll be back in a few minutes with someone else here at the Jemison Empire Awards 2016. In the meantime, down Periscope.